Welcome to the theater and the stage door's production of A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum. I don't know if you've heard, but there is a bit of plague going around, so as an offering to the gods, we've left some seats open. Now, you know how fickle they can be, so please remain in your assigned seat and wear a mask or other face covering throughout the show. If you are uncomfortable with your assignment, the box office can make the proper appeasements to Jupiter and Juno for a new assignment. Please take this time to silence your carrier pigeons, whether they be from the Isle of Verizon or Sprint. Also, Dionysus forbids the recording of this performance in any way, including by mosaic, etching, or frieze. There will be a 15-minute intermission with refreshments sold in the front atrium, and the baths are located in the gallery next door. Now, on with the show. Music and lights, please.
With crowns, bring on the lovers, liars, and clowns. something offensive, something for everyone. Now comedy tonight, passions and potions, constant commotions. Something for everyone. Now comedy tonight. Something repulsive, something for everyone. A comedy tonight. Something aesthetic, something balletic. Something for everyone. A comedy tonight.
Nothing with gods, nothing with fate.
Weighty affairs, we'll just have to wait. Nothing that's formal, nothing that's normal. No recitations to be signed. Open up the curtain. Hey! Whoa, 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 whoa. Comedy tonight. It all takes place on a street in Rome, around and about these three houses. First, the house of Erroneous. A befuddled old man abroad now. Abroad, not abroad. In search of his children, stolen in infancy by pirates. A comedy tonight. Arr, arr, arr. Something erratic, something dramatic, something for everyone. A comedy tonight. Frenzy and frolic, strictly symbolic. Something for everyone. A comedy tonight.
And now, the entire company! To start our journey. My robe, my wreath, my wife.
Slaves, stop your cringing and fetch the baggage.
Yes.
Senex, you are master of this house and no help at all. Where is Pseudolus? Where is Hysterium? Summon them! Pseudolus! Hysterium!
Ah, madam, you called?
Yes, Hysterium.
And I answered, ever your humble.
Have you prepared my potions?
Yes, madam. In addition to your usual potions, I've included one for tantrums and one for queasiness.
Oh, thank you, Hysterium, slave of slaves.
I live to grovel.
Hero, come and kiss your mother goodbye.
Yes, mother.
Slave, take the baggage and go before us. You can't.
Yes.
Come away from that house of shame!
I was just standing there saying, shame! Shame. Oh, shame.
Hysterium.
Yes, madam?
Where is Pseudolus?
Where is he indeed? I have not seen him since you dressed Hero this morning.
Tell him that while we are away, he is to watch over Hero. He's to keep him cheerful, well-fed, and far from the opposite sex.
My dear, the boy has to learn sometime.
And when that time comes, you shall tell him.
Yes, dear.
What little you know. Now go and fetch the gift we bring my mother.
Yes, dear.
Morning, father.
Ah, Hero. Your father and I are off to visit my mother in the country. What a joy it would be were you to accompany us, but alas, the sight of anyone in good health fills my mother with rage. There I am. Do you think it will please my mother?
Oh, yes, madam. The craftsmanship is superb.
And the resemblance?
Frightening.
The time of farewell is at hand. Hysterium, slave in chief, here are my husband's final instructions. In his absence, his entire household is to be in your spotless care. Your word shall be absolute, your authority unquestioned.
And furthermore...
We are on our way!
We're on our way.
Farewell, beloved son. Farewell, thoughtful Hysterium. Senex, come along and carry my bust with pride. Senex!
Yes, dear? Lesson for you all, never fall in love during a total eclipse.
Well, to work. Now that I am completely in charge, I'm going to be a very busy slave. No, oh, here, come away from there. You must never know what goes on in that house.
But I do know.
You do? Isn't it amazing? Oh, can't stand here talking. Pseudolus!
you. I've been feeling very strange. Either something's in the air or else a change is happening in me. I think I know the cause. I hope I know the cause. From everything I've heard, there's only one cause. Love, I hear, makes you sigh a lot. Also, love, I hear, leaves you weak. Love, I hear, makes you blush and turns you ashen. You try to speak with passion and squeak. I hear love, they say, makes you pine away. But you pine away with an idiotic grin. I pine, I blush, I squeak, I squawk. Today I woke too weak to walk. What's love? I hear, I feel, I fear, I'm in. Da da da, ba da ba ba da. See what I mean? Da ba da ba da ba da. I hum a lot too. I'm dazed, I'm pale, I'm sick, I'm sore. I've never felt so well before. What's love? I hear, I feel, I fear, I know I am, I'm sure, I mean, I hope, I trust, I pray, I must be in. Forgive me if I shout, forgive me if I crow, I've only just found out, and well, I thought you ought to
know. Citizen, this is your slave. He was parading as a citizen.
Believe me, master, I was not parading. This is parading. I was walking.
Come back.
He invited us to game with him, and in a matter of moments, he had taken all our money.
He was using weighted dice.
Return the money.
He took 9 minae.
9? I took 7.
Give them 9.
1, 2, 3, 4. I am being cheated out of the money I won fairly.
Pseudolus.
7, 8.
What happened? 5, 6.
I'm coming to them. 9, 5, 6.
Come, fellow citizens.
I should be whipped. Gently. But I only did it for money. I thought if I could raise enough, you'd let me buy my freedom from you.
Pseudolus, not this again.
It's all I think about. I hate being a slave.
Well, better a slave than a slave to love.
Well, that's easy for you. Love. You? Tell me, master, who is she? Anyone I know.
Sometimes you can see her through that window.
Through that window? A courtesan in the house of Lycus. Do you know how many manai a girl like that would cost?
Worth every drachma!
Your parents would be outraged if they could hear you.
Oh, I don't care. Oh, Pseudolus, I would give anything for her.
You would? You really love this girl? I like the way you said that. Now, you cannot afford to buy this girl, but in spite of that, suppose someone with tremendous cunning and guile could arrange for her to be yours.
Yes?
If that someone could arrange it, what would you give me?
Everything.
Everything? What do you own? 20 manai, a collection of seashells, and me.
Right.
You don't have to give me the 20 manai or the seashells. If I get you that girl, just give me me.
Give you
you? My freedom!
Pseudolus, people do not go about freeing slaves.
Be the first. Start a fashion.
Get me that girl.
And if I can,
you are free.
I am what?
Free. Free.
Oh, what a word. Oh, what a word. Say it again.
Free.
I've often thought, I've often dreamed how it would be. And yet I never thought I'd be. Once more.
Free.
But when you come to think of such things, no man should have the rights that all others. Can you imagine what it will be like when I am? Can you see me? Can you see me as a Roman with my head unbowed? Sing it good and loud.
Free.
Like a Roman having rights and like a Roman proud. Can you see me?
I can see you.
Can you see me as a voter fighting graft and vice? Sing it soft and nice. Why, I'll be so conscientious that I may vote twice. Can you see me? Can you see me? When I'm free to be whatever I want to be. Think what wonders I'll accomplish then. When the master that I serve is me and just me. Can you see me being equal with my countrymen? Can you see me being Pseudolus the citizen? Can you see me being given to me once again?
Free!
That's it!
Free!
Yes!
Free!
Now, not so fast, I didn't think. The way I am, I have a roof, 3 meals a day. And I don't have to pay a thing. I'm just a slave and everything's free. If I were free, then nothing would be free. And if I'm beaten now and then, what does it matter?
Free!
Can you see me? You see me as a poet writing poetry. All my verse will be
free.
A museum will have me pickled for posterity. Can you see me?
I can see you.
Can you see me as a lover, one of great renown, women falling down?
Free?
No, but I'll buy the house of Lycus for my house in town. Can you see me? Can't you see me? Be you anything from king to baker of cakes. You're a vegetable unless you're free. It's a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. It's the necessary essence of democracy. It's the thing that every slave should have the right to be. And I soon will have the right to buy a slave for me. Can you see him? Well, I'll free him. When a Pseudolus can move, the universe shakes. But I'll never move until I'm free. Such a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. I'll be Pseudolus, the founder of a family. I'll be Pseudolus, the pillar of society. I'll be Pseudolus, the man, if I can only be
free.
Sing it!
Free!
Spell it!
F-R-W.
No, the long way.
F-R-E-E. Free!
What a day, what a day. Come out here! What do you think you are doing, eunuch? I have told you 1,000 times not to fan the girls while they're still wet. You'll never learn. You'll be a eunuch all your life. Oh, what a day. I have to go to the Senate this morning. I'm blackmailing one of the senators.
Your money back, quick! Good morning, Lycus!
I know that sound, and I love it. Is that money?
What do you think?
How'd you come to all this?
An unexpected legacy. My uncle Simo, the noted Carthaginian elephant breeder, came to an untimely end. He was crushed to death on the last day of the mating season. This morning I bought my freedom.
Congratulations.
With this much left over for one gross indulgence.
Good.
Lycus, I am now in the markets for a lifetime companion. Tell me, have you anything lying about in there? Anything to satisfy an Olympian appetite.
Pseudolus friend and citizen, I have traveled the world in search of beauty. And I can say with modesty that I have the finest assortment in Rome.
Show me.
Eunuch! A buyer! There is merchandise for every need at the house of Marcus Lycus.
All the merchandise is guaranteed at the house of Marcus Lycus.
For a sense of sensuality,
or an opulence thereof, patronize the house of Marcus Lycus, merchant of love. Here are the fruits of my search. Behold, Tintinabula, out of the east, with the face of an idol, the arms of a willow tree, and the pelvis of a camel. Ooh, very camel-like.
But is it right for me? You see what I mean? Isn't she a bit too short?
Definitely not.
Too tall?
No, like that you look perfect together.
Yes, but how often will we find ourselves in this position? Perhaps if we,
No need to compromise. Consider the Gemini. A matched pair. Each one a divinely assembled woman. Together, an infinite number of mathematical possibilities.
It's like synchronized swimming, but on land. Oh, now I remember. You were at the Olympics. Gold medals, girls, gold medals.
Thank you.
That's flawless. I quite agree. But I am a man of limited means. And I don't suppose you'd break up a set?
Oh, I couldn't. You understand.
Completely.
Fortunately, we still have vibrata. Exotic as a desert blue. Wondrous as a flamingo.
Live as a tigress.
The man whose interest is wildlife.
Oh, please come here. You're such a pretty aren't you? Oh, I love that.
I must let you know I'm allergic to cats. The damage is caught in my respiratory compartment!
Bessie! No! No! Bad kitty! Bad Simba! sight to behold. But I get the feeling there is something wrong. Perhaps a cleft palate, a hammer toe.
Wait! I know exactly what you want.
Shut!
May I present Gymnasia! Gymnasia. A giant stage on which 1,000 dramas can be played.
Oh, mommy! Lycus, may I see you back here a moment? $200 minae for what?
Figure it out for yourself.
Yes, it is a fair price by the pound. But what disturbs me, frankly, is the upkeep. Perhaps you'd have better luck selling her to some fraternal organization. A group dedicated to good works.
Oh, but on the other hand...
Pseudolus! Yes, darling?
Do you want your freedom?
More than ever. May I see the next girl?
That is the entire lot. Surely there is one among these to satisfy you.
As yet, I have not seen exactly what I had in mind.
Courtesans, out of the sun and into the house. I shall return in time to lead you in midday prayers. Oh.
What do we do?
Pseudolus! There she is!
Oh, you fox! That is the entire lot. Did I not just spy a golden head and a pair of sky blue eyes? A body clad in flowing white?
Oh, that one? A recent arrival from Crete. A virgin.
A virgin?
A virgin!
Well, only yesterday she was sold.
Sold? Behave yourself! She was sold.
To the great captain, Miles Gloriosus, who comes this day to claim her. She cost 500 minae.
500?
A great sum, to be sure, but being a man of conquest, his heart was set on a virgin.
You say she just arrived from Crete?
Yes.
Oh, I hope the great captain is kind to her. She deserves a bit of affection before... Tragic, is it not?
What is tragic?
The news from Crete.
What news?
Why should I darken your day? Farewell, Lycus.
Well, what is the news?
What news?
The news from Crete.
I heard it. Tragic.
Pseudolus.
You forced me to tell you. Crete is ravaged by a great plague. People are dying by the thousands.
Oh, but this girl is healthy. She goes smiling through the day.
She doesn't? I thought you knew. When they start to smile, the end is near.
No.
Yes. I am told it is lovely now in Crete. Everyone lying there,
smiling. Is it contagious?
Did you ever see a plague that wasn't?
My other girls!
You'd best get her out of there.
Yes.
And then? I could look after her until the captain comes.
He could. But would you not be...
No, I've already had the plague. I would tell you all about it, but...
I do hope she lives until the captain gets here.
Oh, Pseudolus, I am to be with her!
Until the captain arrives.
Yes.
Wait!
Yes?
A brilliant idea!
Yes!
That's what we have to find, a brilliant idea.
No. You must find one!
Come, this way, my dear. Don't touch that pillar! Here is someone I want you to meet. Philia, this is Pseudolus. You are to stay with him until the captain comes. It will not be long. Pseudolus? Thank you, Pseudolus. If there were none in the house to your liking, there will soon be new arrivals. You shall have first choice, because Pseudolus, you are a friend.
Ooh. And you, Lycus, are a gentleman and a procurer.
Oh.
There they are, together. And I must keep them that way together if I am to be free. What to do? What to do? I need help. I'll go to the harbor. There I may find a way out. I'm off. Ooh, the captain. Watch for him. He may arrive this way, or he may arrive this way. No. You watch this way, and you watch that way. Much better. Oh, don't worry. Nothing will happen. He's a virgin, too.
My name is Philia.
Yes?
I do not know your name, but you have beautiful legs.
My name is Hero, and you have beautiful legs, I imagine.
I would show them to you, but they are sold.
I know.
No.
Along with the rest of me. I cost 500 minai. Is that a lot of money?
Oh, yes.
More than 300?
Nearly twice as much.
Those are the two numbers that mix me up. 3 and 5. I hope the captain doesn't expect me to do a lot of adding.
You can't add?
We are taught beauty and grace and no more. I cannot add, or spell, or anything. I have but one talent.
You know what?
What?
That girl about whom you think the worst is my daughter.
Your what?
My daughter. You've heard me speak of her.
Never!
Well, I don't like to talk about her.
That girl is not your daughter.
My sister?
I shall go tell his parents.
Wait, Hysterium, the truth. She has been sold to a captain who comes any moment now to claim her.
Oh. I go tell his parents.
I go with you.
Oh, you don't want to be there when I tell them about you.
No, I want you to be there when I tell them about you.
Tell them what about me? I have nothing to fear. I am a pillar of virtue.
I go. I think it might be of interest to the family that their slave in chief, their pillar of virtue, has secreted within the confines of his cubicle Rome's most extensive and diversified collection of erotic pottery.
Oh, Pseudolus! Ah, hero!
Tell me, where did you ever get that fruit bowl with the freeze of?
Pseudolus! Hero! Hero! As you know, your mother and father placed me in charge of your innocence. However, I have decided to allow you to remain with the girl until the arrival of her captain.
Ophelia!
Yeah, here, stop doing that! You could hurt each other.
Master, I said we needed a brilliant idea.
Yes?
I have been to the harbor and I have found one. Come.
Are we going somewhere?
You are. You have your belongings. Let us fetch yours.
Where are we to go?
Away.
Where away?
Far away.
But my family.
My captain.
There is only room for two of you.
Where?
In the Tiber there sits a boat, gently dipping its bow. Trim and tidy and built to float, pretty little picture. Now, put a boy on the starboard side, leaning out at the rail. Next to him put a blushing bride, slim and slender and starry-eyed. Down below put a tiny bed, the sun gets pale, the sea gets red. And off they sail on the first high tide, the boat and the bed and the boy and the bride. It's a pretty little picture. Oh my, pretty little picture, how true, pretty little picture, which I, Pseudolus, must give to you. Feel the roll of the playful waves, see the sails as they swell, hear the whips on the galley slaves, pretty little picture. Well, glad to carry your cares away, out of sight, out of mind. Past the buoy and through the bay, soon there's nothing but sea and spray. Night descends and the moon's aglow, your arms entwined, your sail below. And far behind, at the edge of day, the bong of the bell of the buoy and the bay, and the boat and the boy and the bride are away. It's a pretty little picture to share, as the little boat sails to sea. Take a little trip free as air, have a little freedom on me. Ocean and ivory, I love smooth and sexy and pink.
Oh, I love
filled with lemons and nuts and
lemons.
Little picture,
in
a cottage of cypress trees, seashells dot the door.
Seashells dot the
boy and bride live a life of ease, doing nothing but what they please. And every night when the stars appear, there's nothing more to see or hear. There's just the shore where the lovers lie,
the sand
and the sea. Song. And the sound of a soft little satisfied sigh. All your catchy little problems will cease, and a little blessing will grow, and a little family increase. Pretty little picture, no, no, pretty little masterpiece. Pretty little masterpiece. Pretty little picture. Come, we go.
Yes.
Wait, I cannot go.
Why can you not?
As long as the captain has a contract, I must go with him. That is the way of a courtesan.
Oh, Venus, why did you bring us together only to part us?
Be brave, Horatio!
happiness.
We will have to learn to be happy without it.
Can you believe this? Have you been listening? And not a word about me or my freedom. She must go with him.
This waiting out here is torture. Why doesn't he come and take me?
In time, you will be taken. But not on the street. Inside.
You will tell me when he comes.
I shall have him knock on the door 3 times.
That's 2 and 1 more?
Correct. 3 times. Now in!
Pseudolus, what is going to happen?
She will go with you.
Hero, I'm off to market. While you are alone with the girl, remember who you are. I have yet to begin my daily chores.
Hysterium, before you go, just 1 more favor.
What is it?
May I borrow your book of potions?
No. That stays right here, where it belongs. Oh, you there, bird seller. What do you have in the way of a plump peahen?
His book of potions and my pass to freedom. What I need is his potent sleeping potion. With a drop or two of that, the breath stops short, the eyes slam shut, the body hangs limp. I shall mix a few drops in a beaker of wine and give it to the girl to drink. I tell Lycus she has died of the plague, and tell Hero to dispose of the body. Then they to the boat, I to the hills, and you to your homes.
Oh, okay.
I just remembered something frightening. I cannot read. Hero, come out here. Call these pages off to me.
Not now.
Yes, now. Our plan depends upon it. Read.
Fever potion.
Uh-uh.
Headache potion.
No.
Passion potion. Sleeping potion.
That's it. The formula. What do we need? The ingredients.
The eye of an eel.
That we have.
The heart of a snail.
That we have.
A cup of mare's sweat.
Mare's sweat? That we have not.
Why are you preparing this?
I intend to give it to the girl. Asleep, she will go with you.
She will?
Mare's sweat.
Where will you find it?
Leave that to me. You go to the harbor, give the boatman your 20 minae, and tell him you sail with him this day. I shall prepare the potion.
This is exciting!
Isn't it? Go! Mare sweat. Where am I going to find mare sweat on a balmy day like this?
Pseudolus! 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 He could have taken this to the stone cutters for me. I dropped it. And now the nose needs to be resharpened. Hysterium will take it for me.
Take me! Take me!
What did you say?
Take me!
Just a moment. Your body is mine.
Then take me. Is this not what you want?
It has crossed my mind now and then.
You must know one thing.
What's that?
Though you have my body, you shall never have my heart.
Well, you can't have everything. 1,000 thanks, whichever one of you did this.
Would you believe it? There was a mare sweating not 2 streets from here. Oh, gets to look more like his father every day.
Pseudolus, he is here.
No!
Remember where we stopped.
Sir, you're back.
She almost broke it.
You've returned.
Ah, yes.
Unexpectedly.
Apparently. Who is she?
I shall await your bidding.
Yes, dear.
Ever your servant.
Ever my servant.
Yes, sir, your servant, your new maid. We needed someone to help.
A new maid? She seems very loyal.
And very efficient, and very courteous, and very thoughtful.
Maids like me, I'm neat. I like maids, they're neat. Something no household should be without. Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a working girl. Everybody ought to have a lurking girl to putter around the house. Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a menial, consistently congenial, and quieter than a mouse. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delicious, tidying up the dishes, neat as a pin? Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful, sweeping out, sleeping in? Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Some whom you hire when you're short of help to offer you the sort of help you never get from a spouse. Fluttering down the stairway, puttering up the bathroom, in the bedroom, in the master, puttering all around the house. Oh, oh, would she be delicious, tying up the dishes, neat as a pin? Oh, oh, would she be delightful, sweeping out, sleeping in? Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Who would hire you to dip for a will? And if you can, as graceful as a grouse. Skittering down the hallway, flittering through the parlor, tippering in the pantry, luring up the bedroom, puttering all around the house.
When she's just been traipsing about. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful living in,
giving out?
Everybody ought to have a maid. Tidily collecting bits of paper and strings, appealing in her apron strings, beguiling in her blouse.
Pattering through the attic,
chattering in the cellar,
clattering in the kitchen,
clattering in the bedroom,
puttering all around the house. The house! The house! The house!
A maid!
A maid!
A maid!
A maid!
Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who's efficient and reliable, obedient and pliable, and quieter than a mouse. Oh, oh! Wouldn't she be so nimble, filling with her thimble, mending a gown? Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful,
cleaning up, leaning down?
Ooh. Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who'll be busy as a bumblebee, and even if they're bumblebee, as graceful as a grouse.
Wriggling in the ante room,
jiggling in the living room,
giggling in the dining room, wiggling in the other room,
muttering all around.
Both of you are. Therefore, it falls to me to instruct her in the niceties of housework. We shall start in my room.
Sir! Sir! Your son is in there.
Oh. Before my friend and neighbor Erroneous went abroad in search of his children stolen in infancy by pirates, he asked me to look into his house from time to time. Now is as good a time as any. I shall chat to the girl in there. Send her to me.
Sir!
Yes?
Only my great devotion to you allows me to speak so frankly. You trudged on the road quite some way, and I fear the great physical exertion.
Is that me?
Yes, sir.
My heavens. I smell like an overheated horse. I shall have to bathe.
At least.
Oh.
for all the lie that I ever let her in the house. I should have never listened to you.
Everything is going to be fine, pussycat.
Oh, you. You just see that she gets out of that house.
And you just see that he stays in that house. Keep calm.
Calm, calm. Mustn't get excited. Calm, calm. Calm, calm. Calm. Perfectly calm. I'm utterly under control. I haven't to worry where others would hurry. I stroll. I'm calm, cool, a gibbering fool is something I never become. When thunder is rumbling and others are crumbling, I hum. Was thick, calm, comforting things, butterfly wings, emerald creeks, or a murmuring brook, murmuring, murmuring, murmuring. Look, I'm calm, I'm calm, I haven't a qualm, I'm utterly under control. Let nothing confuse me or faze me. Oh, excuse me. I'm calm, oh, so calm. Oh,
Mysterio!
So coming, sir! Oh,
ah, home at last, after years of searching for my long-lost children. How good it is to see the street once more. These tired old eyes fill with tears at the sight of the little they see. Pardon me, young woman. I was just, that is, I mean to say, lovely baby. About the age of my children, when they were stolen by pirates. Well, at least I have the comfort of my lonely house.
Sir.
And who are you?
Hysterium, sir. Servant to Senex.
Well, yes, of course. I should have known you anywhere.
Everybody ought to have.
What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Everybody ought to have.
Didn't hear that either.
You did not hear that eerie sound?
Eerie?
Eerie as if haunted.
Eerie as if haunted. Sir, what I am about to tell you is eerie. Your house. Haunted!
Haunted?
Ooh, as haunted as the day is long.
Impossible. My house haunted, you say? Strange.
But true. Perhaps you ought to stay with relatives, sir. Distant relatives!
Yes. No! Fetch me a soothsayer.
A soothsayer?
Yes, I must have him search my house immediately.
You are in need of a soothsayer?
How did you know?
Well, I'd be a fine soothsayer if I didn't. Silence! I am about to say the sooth! Wait! I see everything. You have been abroad.
Yes, yes.
For 20 years. Oh, you have been searching for a child, two children.
Yes, yes.
Oh, a fine big boy and a strange little boy. A girl! A girl! Yes. A boy and a girl!
Yes. Can you find them for me?
Certainly I can. can find them for you.
Each wears a ring on which there's engraving a gaggle of geese.
A gaggle of what?
A gaggle of geese. Look! There are only two like it in the world, and two others like it. And my children wear them.
How many geese in a gaggle?
Geese? Seven.
Seven? Then before I say the sooth again, you must walk seven times around the seven hills of Rome.
Seven times? Slowly. Seven times around the seven... Take it all back to the harbor. My house is haunted.
Everybody ought to have...
And the spirit?
It shall be gone by the time you have done, my bidding.
Thank you.
To the hills!
To the hills!
This is the way, sir.
Thank you, young woman.
Sir, you forgot your gaggle.
Hysterium.
Sir!
Prepare my back.
Yes, sir.
Pseudolus, that little maid, do you know what her first words were to me? She said, take me.
And you shall, sir.
I'll try.
Yes, sir.
Remember, Hysterium, not too hot and not too cold.
Philia? Philia!
Son!
Father! Where's mother?
Where? I have returned without her. Pressing business. Lovely new maid.
New maid?
Pseudolus told me about her.
Oh.
Presently, my dear. Why did he look at her that way? Why did he look at her that way? Must be my imagination. She's a lovely blooming flower, he's just a sprout. Impossible, she's a lovely blooming flower, he's all worn out. Impossible, just a fledgling in the nest, just a man who needs a rest. He's a beamish boy at best. Poor old fellow, he's a child who loves a test, he's too young to pass. Impossible, he has asthma, gout, a wife, lumbago, and gas. Irascible, romping in the nursery. He looks tired. Son, sit on your father's knee. Father, you can lean on me. He's a handsome lad of plenty, I'm 39. It's possible. Older men know so much more. In a way, I'm 44. Next to him, I'll seem a fool. All right, 50. Then again, he is my father. I ought to trust. Impossible. Then again, with love at my age, sometimes it's just impossible. With a girl, ill at ease. I don't feel well, sir, about those birds and bees. Son, a glass of water, please. The situation's fraught, broader than I thought. With horrible, impossible possibilities.
Soonless.
Son, it grieves me to see a boy of your age moving, and moping about the house. Pseudolus, I want you to take Hero to the baths.
Sir, very good, sir. Allow me to finish a brew Master Hero asked me to prepare. Master, I shall meet you in front of the baths of Aqua Selena. You know where it is? Next to the harbor. And I shall have a surprise for you.
Yes, yes, of course.
Farewell, Father. Farewell, Pseudolus.
Well, he to his bath and I to mine.
Just the way you like it, sir.
Oh, Hysterium, one more thing.
Yes, sir.
I shall need a complete change of garb. Let's see, my tunic with the tassels.
Sir, it needs taking in.
Well, take it in and bring it out.
The girl, I want to know the worst. How is she?
She is very low.
Still smiling.
Laughing!
Oh,
there is one hope. I have prepared a plague potion. If it is not too late, we may yet save her life.
Give it to her.
Yes. Ho there! I seek the house of Marcus Lycus.
Who heeks this house of Marcus Lycus?
Hold, sir.
But he who...
You're not holding. Who is he who seeks the house of Marcus Lycus?
A foot soldier of Captain Miles Gloriosus.
Smartly done.
My captain has dispatched me to inform you that he is but half a league away. Prepare to greet him.
Half a league!
We have only moments.
I'll give her the potion.
Yes.
Yes.
Wait, what? Don't leave me.
Why not?
He's coming.
I know he's coming.
You speak to him. I'll give her the potion.
Wait, you can't give her the potion?
Why not?
You'll catch the plague.
Ooh, I don't want the plague.
I've got to give her the potion.
Yes.
Yes.
Wait,
what?
She's in the House of Senex.
Oh, what will we do? Does he know which house is your house?
No.
This is your house.
Will he believe it?
Get the girls.
Good.
I'll give her the potion.
And I'll get the girls.
Good.
Yes.
Yes.
Wait!
What is it?
I forgot.
Lycus, we must not lose our heads.
Yes.
No!
We must remain calm!
Oh, Pseudolus, you must speak to the captain. I have no talent for bravery.
You give me permission to represent you.
Complete.
All right, collect the courtesans and bring them out. Then you are to wait in your house.
Oh, Pseudolus, I am eternally grateful. I am your friend until death.
Go!
Yes.
No!
Wait!
No! No!
Ho there. We seek the house of Marcus Lycus.
Who likes the films of Georges Lucas?
Captain Miles Gloriosus.
He is but a quarter league away and bids you honor this.
Oh, yes, of course.
Do you know what this is, sir?
Of course I know what this is! Oh, this is writing.
It is your contract with the captain.
And a pretty piece of work. What is this word here?
That's Lycus.
Ah. Then you know to whom you are speaking to.
Yes, sir.
And do you see what it says there?
It says words. And I intend to stand behind those words, or my name is not Marcus Lycus. But my name is not Pseudolus Marcus Lycus. A moment, I must speak with my eunuch. Come here, eunuch!
Oh. How dare you call me that?
You know it's not true, and I know it's not true, so what do we care what they think?
Those soldiers, have they come for the girl? I'll go right in and get her.
They haven't come for the girl. They've come for me.
What?
Hysterium, I never told you this, but years ago, I deserted from the army.
No.
Shh. I was very young. I wanted to be an archer. Instead, they made me a slinger. Then, one day at the height of battle, I lost my head. I arched when I should have slung. I had to flee. Oh, and now they have found you. Oh, Pseudolus.
Shh, they're looking for Pseudolus. I told them I am Lycus. And Lycus you are. Rely on me.
I must. Hysterium, there is more bad news.
I hope it's good.
It's terrible. The girl refuses to go with her captain. That is why I have prepared your sleeping potion. You are to give her a few drops and a beaker of wine. And upon hearing me say, present the bride, carry her out in your arms.
Count on me, Pseudo. Count on me, Lycus. I go, Lycus. Farewell, Lycus.
Bid your captain come. His bride awaits him. Doesn't anybody march anymore? Lycus! The girls, quickly!
Yes! Eunuchs, the girls, quickly! We shall pose them informally.
Give the place a friendly look.
Don't you lower your voice to me.
You are to do exactly as Pseudolus fans. He will represent me.
All you girls over here. And you eunuchs. Lycus, do we really need these eunuchs?
Into the house.
Into the house. Into the house.
You there. You there. You there. You there. Oh, there's so much of you there.
First time around.
Now may I have your attention? You are all about to meet a great captain. Remember who you are and what you stand for. Now will you all please strike vocational attitudes? Perfect. I would like a mosaic of this scene. An entire wall made of...
The captain again, my heart fell.
It is!
Stand aside, everyone! I take large steps.
Marcus Lycus, sir, I am dazzled by your presence.
Everyone is.
Welcome to my house, great captain. Your bride awaits you.
My bride. My bride, my bride. Come to claim my bride. Come tenderly to crush her against my side. Let haste be made. I cannot be delayed. There are laughs to conquer cities.
A short delay, sir.
What happened? Well, I'll tell you what happened. Nothing. She won't drink.
What?
She says on Crete.
My religion forbids it.
Oh, he had to fall in love with a religious Cretan. I'll get her to drink.
Good luck.
Captain, forgive the girl. She primps. She preens. She wants to be worthy of so great a warrior.
Understandable. I am a legend in my own time. Men, close rank. Stand tall. Lycus! Where is my bride?
Did she not come through this door?
No. What are you saying, man?
The virgin has escaped!
Oh no! The beautiful bride I bargained for!
Vanished!
This is monstrous!
It certainly is, but look at it this way. Since I cannot deliver her to you, you do not have to pay me the 500 minae.
I already paid the 500 minae through my agents! Has the money escaped as well?
There's been a little mistake. I was only joking. Lycus will pay you.
What?
I was helping out a friend. Allow me, great captain. Come out here! Here is your man. Tell him who I am.
Well, everyone knows who you are, Lycus.
Oh, of course! He is Marcus Lycus.
No! He is Lycus! This is his house!
Well, look within, sir. You will find none here but hooded men. We are a holy order, an ancient brotherhood of lepers!
Unclean!
And bless you, Lycus.
What now, Lycus?
What?
I'll tell you what. With that said pike, my soldiers shall raise this house to the ground!
Oh, our beautiful house!
And as for you, you shall receive the ultimate punishment, death!
Please, sir, please, may I be allowed a word?
A word?
One word!
It had better be a good one.
Oh, it is, sir.
What is it?
Intermission!
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a 15-minute intermission. 15 minutes.
Welcome again, playgoers. You are about to witness the second half of our play. Permit me to remind you where we were when last you saw us. The virgin was waiting. That's what they do best. Waiting here in the house for her captain to claim her. She has refused to drink the potion on religious grounds. Senex awaits the maid in his neighbor's house, hopefully about to sow his last oat. Lycus skulks about the city, searching for Philia. Hero is at the baths, where he sits and soaks. His mother is on the way to the country to visit her mother, 104 years old and not one organ in working condition. The courtesans, Miles Gloriosus and his mighty warriors, Hysterium and Pseudolus are here. Let the play continue.
Sir! Grab him! And now I rid Rome of a rascal.
Sir! The girl must be near at hand. If you kill me, you deprive yourself of seeing a face so fair, a heart so pure, a body so undulating. She is magnificence personified. If you had been born a woman, you would have been she.
As magnificent as that?
Yes, sir. Spare me, I am sure she can be found.
You are?
Yes, sir. I shall give you a list of 10 or 20 places you might look for her.
You shall look for her.
Me? With this bad leg?
With that bad leg?
Yes, it will do it good. And where will I deliver the girl? I mean, where will you be?
Waiting here in your house.
No!
No?
I meant yes, it just came out no.
And to assure your return, men, you ought to go with me.
Sir, before I go, may I speak with my eunuch?
Be brief.
Yes, sir. Come here, eunuch! Hysterium, this is what you must do. Hide the girl up on the roof.
Why?
Why not? Go!
Okay.
He is not to stray from your sight.
My eunuch is making sure the house is fit to receive so illustrious a visitor.
I have been put off enough for one day.
Second time round!
Lycus!
Yes, sir. Ready?
Ready!
All is ready, sir. There is food and drink within, and the girls will sing and dance for you.
You have but 1 hour. Men, you are to hound his every step.
Hello, boys. Shall we? Wait!
Hysterium?
Yes, sir?
Tell the maid I am almost ready.
Sir, I must say this to you. Abandon this mad adventure. Think of your wife on the way to the country.
That, Hysterium, is the country's problem.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Hysterium, you know of that potion that you prepared that so fills one with passion, one can almost perform miracles?
Yes, sir. I believe we have some left over from your last anniversary.
Bring it to me now, slave in chief.
Slave in chief? I wonder how many slaves in chief have a master in the tub, a house full of courtesans, and a virgin on the roof!
Well, boys, this 5K fundraiser for the plague is going very well. Okay, wait, I need to check my pulse. Big men like me, we pass out easy. You good? All right, let's go. Now, switch leap. Torsjeté. And, personal favorite, the moonwalk. Oh, boys, please excuse me. I need to take care of a spastic colon. What are you doing? Don't follow me! Hero, fetch my brown pants! Just 1 hour. Pretending she was dead was the perfect plan. If only Philia had taken one sip. Oh, it still is the perfect plan if I could only find a body. A body. Gusto! Gusto, the body snatcher! He owes me a favor!
Since sending my husband back to Rome, I have been haunted by the premonition that he is up to something low. Hysteria!
Coming, master or mistress? You're home.
Oh, harsh with thirst ever thought.
No, it's a potion.
What sort of potion?
To make you thirsty, and you're already thirsty, so you don't need it.
Thirst is the lesser of my problems. Hysterium, on the best of intuition, I believe my husband is fouling the nest.
No, never.
Never? Old friend and confidant, you are talking to a woman who faces facts. For over 30 years, I've cried myself to sleep, assailed my doubts and fears so great the gods themselves would weep. The moment I am gone, I wonder where he'll go. With all your simple honesty, you can't begin to know.
I think it's a captain.
A captain?
Yes, he believes that your house is the house of... I do hope you do not object to my offering him your hospitality.
Object? When I myself am the daughter of a Roman general. Hysterium, I must meet him.
Oh, you wouldn't like him. He's very vulgar.
All soldiers are, in a grand sort of way.
Interminable! Bring me some more food and drink, eunuch.
Ah, you see?
Captain! I was just coming inside to give you a proper welcome.
You are of this house?
Oh, for years and years. You know, Captain, my father was General Magnus. On the last anniversary of his death, I entertained over 200...
200?! By yourself?
Oh, no, of course not. Hysterium here was a great help. But now, my business takes me to the forum. But I shall return, and for the length of your stay, I shall bend over backwards to please.
Oh no, that shall not be necessary.
I do wish I could chat on with him, but I must find out why my husband was so anxious to return to Rome. Hysteria, when next we meet, I shall be in some form of disguise. If you recognize me, not a word. Until later, Captain.
Yes.
Oh, Pseudolus, busy as ever.
Yes, madam. She's back, yes? What has happened?
What hasn't happened?
All right, what hasn't happened? She hasn't found out, has she?
No.
Oh, God.
But she will, and she'll kill me.
No, she won't.
No, she won't. I'll kill myself. I can do it painlessly. If she does it, it'll hurt. Oh, I must do it. I have besmirched the honor of my family. My father will turn in his grave.
Your father's alive.
This will kill him.
Are you finished? Now listen to this. I have really shocking news.
What?
You know Gusto, the body snatcher.
Yeah.
He died this morning.
What? Oh, no, Gusto! I saw him only yesterday.
Oh, when is he to be buried? They don't know. Somebody snatched the body.
Gusto, it's a shame. Wait. Why are we crying about a dead body snatcher?
Because he could have helped us. He could have lent us a body.
A body?
A body. Hmm? A body. Hysteria, would you like everything to be the way it was when you woke this morning?
In a minute.
That's all it will take. Come!
Oh. In here?
In here.
Where'd you get the money?
Something smells divine. And it's me. I just took the most luxurious bath. The oil... The essences, oh, spectators, I would love to pass among you and give each and every one of you a good whiff. Just a minute. Philia! Oh, mustn't shout. I have to save all of my energy. Philia! Philia!
Yes, Master?
Ah, there you are, my dear, up there. Don't need to dust up there. Come to me.
I am yours.
Yes, but not up there. Join me in this house.
Yes, sir.
Oh, where is he? If he does not bring me my bride, he shall see me at the height of my wrath!
In time to say farewell.
Did not Pseudolus bring you a beaker of wine?
My religion forbids the drinking of wine.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes.
Philia!
The captain, I must go to him.
I hate him!
So do I, and I have a way to make him suffer.
Let the captain wed me, and through me I shall play my part. Let him make his mouth.
In there? Oh, no, no, no. He was in there. He had to go to the Senate for an unexpected ovation.
Really?
Of course.
Does he still want me to wait on the roof?
Yes.
Leave me alone!
No, no, wait, in the garden.
In the garden?
Yes, behind that large lump clump of myrrh.
You will tell me when he comes.
Don't we always?
Oh, Hamlet.
Hero.
Hero. If only you could buy me from the captain.
If Hero has the captain's contract, you will go with him? Oh, it shall be arranged. Into the garden! Yep, yep! Pretty light for a stone bench. Come out here! Come on out! Tell me I'd have to be a girl. A dead girl. The captain will see you go on his way and all will be well.
No, won't do.
Hysterium, please. We must convince the captain.
That I'm a beautiful dead girl.
Yes.
He'll never believe it.
He will. You're delicious.
Hey. What if he tries to kiss me?
He won't kiss you.
Well, how can he help it? I'm so delicious.
Hysterium, please, just lie on the bench.
He'll never believe I'm a girl. Look at me.
Just look at me.
I can't take my eyes off you.
You're lovely. Absolutely lovely. Who'd believe the loveliness of you?
No, come back. Think dead thoughts. Good.
I'm lovely, absolutely lovely. Who'd believe the loveliness of me? Perfect, sweet and warm and winsome, radiant as it's a dream come true. Now,
sure, I have jewelry.
Jewelry?
Here, take the old man's ring.
Flowers.
What?
I should have flowers. Ah, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm so lovely.
Literally lovely, that the world will never seem the same.
You're so
lovely, that the world will never seem the same.
Puts in my eyes, I keep.
Oh, there! Ah, I've been looking everywhere for you. Here is your captain's bride, dead. Give her air! You'd best break the sad news to your captain. Oh.
a virgin. A lot of good it did her.
Oh! Grave mistake. Men support me. How did she die?
Well, she just sort of rolled over
and... Spare me! I cannot control my tears. I must cry!
Go ahead. You'll feel better. It's green. Now that you've seen her, I suggest you depart and torture yourself no longer. I shall dispose of the body.
I cannot leave here without the comfort of a proper funeral service.
Sir, do you have time for that? I mean, isn't there a war somewhere?
Silence! I insist on conducting a funeral.
Yes, sir.
We need mourners.
We have them. Hold him. Firmly.
Poor girl. Having died so young without having ever experienced me.
They will be here presently, sir. While we wait, would you like something to eat?
Oh, thank you. Our bridal bower becomes a burial bier of bitter bereavement.
Very good. Can you say Titus the Tailor told 10 tall tales to Titania the Titmouse?
Do not try and cheer me. I am inconsolable.
Gather round, handmaidens of sorrow.
Sound the flute. Blow the harp. Black the lute.
Men! We
will. Kiss, of course.
God, you!
Sir, you mustn't!
Why not?
It can make you very sick. The truth is, she died of an illness contracted on Crete.
What illness?
The plague!
Return from Crete this day, and I tell you there is no plague.
Then what was everyone yelling about?
Aren't you? This girl's alive!
No, and she's gonna stay that way!
No, wait! Men! After her!
Oh, I'll get her!
Oh, wait!
Now all the courtesans have escaped! Eurex! I stand and lose a fortune in flash! Find the girls, bring them back!
Find the girls, bring them back! Find them!
No, I've got to get out of these clothes! I'm calm.
There you are, my little dove. You don't need to be afraid of me. My slave has prepared a little feast, and I want you to serve it to me in there. Do you understand? Go then.
I'm gonna die. Pseudolus! To give you worse than that! What did you do with the contract? I gave it to a soldier!
He wants to meet me later tonight.
Go get it! I need it!
He got it! Out! This way, men! I found her!
If it's a pretty face, he wants. Oh! How dare you!
Here she is, men! The virgin!
My virgin!
Sir, I am not anybody's virgin!
Oh, you made that more than clear last we met!
Oh, the cause of it all!
Again?
Oh, I've got to get out of these clothes!
No, my dear. Wrong house.
Leave me alone!
You're beautiful when you're angry.
Philia!
Second time around! Five, six, seven, eight!
All is lost!
All is won! The contract! This is what you must
do! You die! The leper!
Leave us, please!
I know you're out here somewhere, my dear. Philia! Philia!
I thought I heard someone call my name.
Find the girls, bring them back. Find the girls, bring them back.
That is where my husband went. I know what goes on in there.
Who doesn't?
Under arrest.
Dearest. Felix, you saw through my disguise.
Yes, beloved.
Forgive me for mistrusting you, darling. It's just that you've been a little distant these last 29 years.
Yes, beloved.
Where are you going?
Business. Pressing business.
Senex? Senex!
Third time around! The spirit! Who are you? Come, let me help you.
Oh, thank you. I'm quite all right.
Wait!
What is it?
My dear one. My sweet one. My little one.
Why do older men find me so attractive?
My daughter!
What?
You wear the ring! The ring with the gaggle of geese!
Oh, I am not your daughter!
There she is!
Yes!
My virgin!
I'm not a virgin!
Those filthy pirates!
I'm not your daughter! I'm an Etruscan dancer!
Dancing with impatience, my dear?
Who is it that speaks so boldly to my virgin?
Your what? She is my name, but my daughter!
Oh, please stop! Oh, wait, please! Oh, please! Oh.
You are not the virgin!
Of course not! I am, this old man's baby daughter.
Hysterian?
The eunuch!
My daughter's a eunuch?
Seize him!
Senex!
Oh, you again.
Sir, you are speaking to my wife.
You're married to that, that...
Yes, I am married to that, that. And I would thank you to release my slave and remove yourself from the front of my house.
But this is the house of Lycus!
Lycus!
Silence! I declare this place under martial law!
Release that man!
Release that man! You!
Sir, this quivering creature is blameless. It is I and I alone who have caused you this grief.
Men, unseize him!
And seize him!
Now, death by evisceration. Pseudolus!
Calm, friend. Sir, I believe a doomed man is allowed a final request.
Yes.
Allow me to take my own life.
Sir, I have seen kings with less courage.
So have I. Hysterium, the potion. You know the one I mean.
The potion?
Oh, thank you, dear friend. Give the hemlock to Socrates.
Which one of you is Socrates?
Give me that!
You!
I go to sail on uncharted seas, to the harbor, from which no mariner returns. So long, farewell, adieu, to you, and you, and you. I imagine death so much it feels more like a memory. Oh, I'm melting! Oh, what a world! There's nowhere I can turn. There's no way to go on. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is I never left you. Freedom! Chino, enough for you! And you! Oh. Rosebud! Never go in against a Sicilian when death is on the line! Kiss me! Somebody kiss me! Anybody! I could kill you, you darling!
Save him!
Oh, thank you, I needed that.
Stop that!
Great Miles Gloriosus, I could not reveal my true identity until I could deliver that which I had promised. Sir, I am Lycus. Philia, go to the man who bought you.
No.
Wash you the captain.
Quiet, we are under martial law.
There is the captain.
Captain,
here is your virgin.
And worth the wait. Men, in joy of this occasion, forgiveness, you are free.
Free to be a slave.
I can't understand it. There was the ring. The ring with the gaggle of geese.
What did you say, old man?
The ring!
Father?
You've grown!
Were these many geese a gaggle?
How long have you had this?
I've had this since, I don't know how long I've had this since.
My daughter!
My sister!
Pseudolus, did you hear that?
Silence! Stand back, everyone! My dear old man, I take it your daughter is freeborn.
Without a doubt.
Lycus, as we all know, the penalty for selling a freeborn citizen is to be trampled to death by a water buffalo in heat.
Seize him!
Careful, I am a bleeder.
Bring out those girls! I told you this was to be a comedy. Hero!
Mother, father, I wish to marry.
Son, if you're only as happy as your mother and I, my heart will bleed for you.
Lovers divided, can coincide, something for everyone.
A comedy tonight.
Father and mother, get one another.
Something for everyone.
A comedy tonight.
I get the twins, they get the best.
I get a family,
I get a rest.
We get a few girls,
I'll get some new girls.
I get the thing I want.
Ha ha ha!